Hello everyone, welcome to Students Point. This is 21st of July and today we have to see 10 selected questions along with some additional facts at the end. So be attentive and be focused till the end. And to get PDF of all these videos, you can join me on Telegram by writing the channel's name like this. And if you are finding this video useful, don't forget to like the video and share the video with your friends and loved ones. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon so that you receive all the notification at the earliest of all the latest important videos and never miss any opportunity to learn and grow every day. And today's question is a bit of different nature. Today I would love to hear your feedback about this daily current affairs series in the comment section. I would love to hear that how much you are finding this series beneficial for your examinations. Let me know today in the comment section. Let's begin the first question now. Form 26AS is related to, so this form is related to tax payment. And this form has recently been rolled out by Income Tax Department with an aim to assist taxpayers in filing up the quickly and correct income tax returns. Next question now. The first International Chess Day is being observed on. So it is being observed globally for the first time in this year only, that is in the year of 2020, on 20th of July. So here C is the right answer. And United Nations General Assembly has proclaimed 20th of July as World Chess Day to mark the date of establishment of International Chess Federation in Paris in 1924. And there was a term called as Chaturang. Chaturang was earlier a game which was quite similar to chess. This Chaturang originated in northern Indian subcontinent during the Guptas period, which continued from 319 to 543 CE. And it spread along the Silk Roads west to Persia. And later a term called as Chaturang, which was also called as Sataranj. You must have heard the word Sataranj. It was the name given to the game when it arrived in Shashinath, Persia around 600 CE. And later we have a new game called as Chess. So we can relate this new game Chess to this Sataranj or Chaturang. Next question now. Consider the following statements about SACU or SACU. It is an economic union? No, this is wrong. See, while we have discussed several times questions on European Union, we have seen that it is very difficult for an organization to emerge into an economic union. So we have only European Union which is emerged as a full successful economic union. So SACU is not an economic union. Here first is wrong. Its members include Botswana, Eswatini, Lesotho, Namibia, South Africa only. This statement is correct. So the SACU is an organization of Africa. It includes mainly the South African countries, which are Botswana, Eswatini, which was earlier called as Swaziland, Lesotho, Namibia, South Africa. Its headquarters is in capital of South Africa's Cape Town. No, this is incorrect. So here only second statement is correct. So here A is the right answer for it. And it was in news because India has revived its preferential trade agreement with SACU. And under this preferential trade agreement, India is supporting manufacturing and industries in these countries. And this mainly includes agriculture, irrigation, information communication technology, renewables and pharmaceuticals. The trade between India and Africa as a whole is $66.7 billion. Out of this $66.7 billion, $10.9 billion trade is with SACU countries. SACU, which stands for South African Custom Unions, it is a custom union among five countries of South Africa. We have seen already these names. Its headquarters are in Namibian capital, which is Windhoek. Remember the capital of this SACU? Windhoek is the capital, headquarters of this organization. This organization was established in 1910. What is a custom union? See, we have earlier seen the different stages of economic integration. So custom union is an advanced level of economic integration. So custom union is generally defined as a type of trade bloc or economic integration in which there is free trade area with a common external tariff. So SACU is a custom union. So let us understand how this SACU works as a custom union. See, if this is the boundary of SACU and it has five countries, we have dealt already. So if this SACU union has to deal with or trade with any country which is not a member of the SACU organization, then these countries will have a common external tariff, that each country will impose common tariff on goods and services supplied from a non-member country to these member countries. Also, within this boundary, these five countries will have a free trade agreement, that is, goods and services will be allowed to freely move within these member countries. So I hope you understand what is custom union. While custom union is different from economic union, how? See, in custom union, though there is free movement of goods and services across the border within the member countries, but there is not free movement of workers. Workers of the member countries, let's say, here five members are in SACU, so workers cannot move freely within these member countries. Only goods and services can be supplied freely within these member countries. While in economic union, there is free movement of workers and capitals as well, along with goods and services. While in custom union, there is also not a common currency. While European Union, which is a economic union as well, there is a common currency called as euro. So I hope you understand the difference between economic union and custom union. So basically, economic union is an advanced level of custom union. So ultimately, custom union, when will evolve, it will ultimately reach to economic union after such agreements. Next question now. Consider the following statements about Bathynomus rhaxus. Rhaxus here means monstrous. Let's see. It is a supergiant newly discovered species in the eastern Indian Ocean near Indonesia. This statement is correct. And it is described as cockroach of the sea, and it has 14 legs and measures around 50 centimeter, that is 1.6 feet. This statement is also correct. So here both of these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And this is how the sea giant looks like. And this Bathynomus rhaxus is a giant isopod in the genus Bathynomus. Bath means those living at the beneath of the sea. And they are found in the cold depth of the Pacific, Atlantic and Indian Oceans. And it is the first supergiant isopod species to be discovered in eastern Indian Oceans. The only member of isopod species that exceeds the rhaxus in size is Bathynomus giganteus, which is commonly found in deep waters of western Atlantic Ocean. Next question now. Which of the following is true for Global Monthly Dimensional Poverty Index 2019? We have already dealt a question on this, but I have taken this question again with some more details in this question. Let's see. It is released by United Nations Development Program. This statement is correct. It is developed by Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative and United Nations Development Program. This statement is also correct. So here both of these statements are correct. Third statement. As per the index, 3.5 billion people in the world are still multidimensionally poor. This data is incorrect. Only 1.3 billion people are multidimensionally poor in the world today. So here this statement is incorrect. Only A and B, or first and second, is correct. So C is the right answer here. And recently the report was released by UNDP, and 2019 edition is revised version of MPI 2018. As per this report, 1.3 billion people are still multidimensionally poor, and level of inequality and poverty is very high in sub-Saharan Africa and South Asia. Bangladesh, Cambodia, Democratic Republic of Congo, or DRC in short, Ethiopia, Haiti, India, Nigeria, and Pakistan, Peru, Vietnam have shown significant progress towards achievement of SDG goal first, which aims to end poverty in all its form. So here you can see some countries which are very poor, like countries like Nigeria, Pakistan, Ethiopia, Democratic Republic of Congo. So they have also been performing better in terms of achieving their target to end poverty. And one in every three children. See, these statements are very useful for UPSC aspirants particularly. You can quote such data in your answer writing as well. And such statements can also be part of your prelims questions. So let's see. One in every three children under the age of 10 and every second child below the age of 18 years is multidimensionally poor in the world. I repeat this data once again, very important. One in every three children who are under the age of 10 and every second children who is below the age of 18 is multidimensionally poor in the world, and about 34% of world children and 17.5% adults covered under multidimensionally poverty index survey are multidimensionally poor. We have seen already what is multidimensionally poor. It means that poverty is not unidimensional, it is multifaceted, that it must be seen in multidimensional form and not only in economic terms. Now let's have some facts about India in this report. It reported that India lifted 271 million people out of poverty between 2006 and 2016. And among the 10 selected countries, India and Cambodia reduced their MPI values the fastest. And Jharkhand in India has reduced the incidence of poverty at a much faster pace than other regions. It has reduced the incidence of multidimensional poverty from 74.9% in 2005-06 to 46.5% in 2015-16. Next question now. Consider the following statements about heavy drop system P7HDS. Let's see. It is a multi-stage parachute system comprising of 5 main canopies, 5 brake chutes and 2 auxiliary chutes, 1 extractor parachute and platform, which is a metallic structure made up of aluminium steel alloys. This statement is correct and it has been developed indigenously by DRDO. See, mark this word, it has been developed by DRDO. So here both of these statements are correct, so C is the right answer. Remember that this system is developed by DRDO but has been manufactured by Larsen & Toubro, which manufactures the platform system, while the parachute manufactured by Ordnance Factory. And this is how this system will look like. It will use to carry the heavy loads for military. Next question now. Consider the following statements about monoclonal antibodies. These are proteins cloned in lab to mimic antibodies produced by the immune system to counter an infection. This statement is correct. So these monoclonal antibodies are cloned in laboratory to mimic antibodies which are produced inside the human body to counter an infection. And they have their genesis in serum, which is the colorless constituent of blood. So serum is the colorless constituent of blood that contains antibodies. So here again, both of these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And these proteins bind to an antigen, which is fragment of an infectious virus in the case of SARS-CoV-2, and either destroy it or block its action. It was in news because pharma major Biocon announced that it has received the approval of Drugs Controller General of India to market itolizumab for treatment of cytokine release syndrome in COVID-19 patients. This itolizumab is a monoclonal antibody which is used to treat acute psoriasis. Next question now. Which of the following is true about Malabar exercise? Let's see. It is a trilateral naval exercise involving United States, Japan and India. This statement is correct. It originally began in 1992 as a trilateral exercise between India, US and Japan. This statement is incorrect. Why? Because this exercise started in 1992 as a bilateral agreement between India and US. So initially it was a bilateral exercise between India and US. Japan joined it later in 2015. It is held only in Indian Ocean? No. It is held both in Indian Ocean as well as in Pacific Ocean in alternate manners. So here only first statement is correct. So here A is the right answer. Recently, India has expressed its willingness to expand the Malabar exercise to include Australia as well. Earlier, India was resistant and reluctant to allow Australia to join in this naval exercise, as Beijing has always opposed coalition of these democracies. And Malabar exercise is an annual trilateral naval exercise between these three countries. It is held alternatively in India and Pacific Ocean. As we've seen, it began in 1992, Japan joined it in 2015. Other exercises with Australia and India includes Pitch Black and Aus Index. Pitch Black, remember this name, it is unique, so you might confuse. Pitch Black exercise held between India and Australia. And if you have not liked the video yet, do like it and share the video with your friends and loved ones. Next question now. S. Seshadri, who lived during 1932 till 2020, passed away recently, was related to. So he was a great mathematician. So here C is the right answer. and he was founder of the Chennai Mathematical Institute and is known for his work in algebraic geometry. The Seshadri constant is named after him, and the Seshadri constant expresses the so-called local positivity of a line bundle on a projective variety. Next question now. Consider the following statements about International Civil Aviation Organization. It was established by Convention on International Civil Aviation, which was signed in the year of 1944 in Chicago. The statement is correct. It aims to foster planning and development of international air transport to ensure the safe and orderly growth of international civil aviation. So here both of the statements are correct. Again, C is the right answer. It is headquartered in Montreal, which is in Canada. The body was in news because International Court of Justice has refused an appeal filed by Bahrain, Saudi Arabia, Egypt and UAE, which challenged the authority of International Civil Aviation Organization to adjudicate on the legality of Qatar blockade. What was the matter? See, these countries imposed a blockade on Qatar in 2017 over the alleged support of Qatar to terrorism. These countries stopped the shipping routes and airspace for Qatar Airlines and Qatar ships. They did not allow their ports to be used by Qatar's entities. They asked Qatar to stop its support to terrorism and ban its news agency, which is Al Jazeera. You must have heard the news from Al Jazeera. So they asked such conditions, which Qatar says that it did not support terrorism in any form, and Qatar had filed an appeal to International Civil Aviation that the blockade imposed by these countries on it restricts its sovereignty and violates its sovereignty. So it is high chances that International Civil Aviation is going to adjudicate in favor of Qatar, which will be huge victory for it. Let's see some more points. Roshni Nadar Malhotra has replaced her father Shiv Nadar as the chairperson of $9.9 billion company HCL, which is the company that her father founded in 1976. With this, she became the first woman chairperson of a listed Indian IT services company. HCL today is the third largest company in IT sector after TCS and Infosys. And Shiv Nadar founded HCL 44 years ago to make calculators and microprocessors. So do like and share the video, subscribe and press the bell icon. Wait for the upcoming video. Until then, stay safe and thanks for watching.